I'd be right back. It should show my kobold. There you go. I'm gonna be painting this guy. And he will be stealing a chicken because they steal stuff. That's my theory. Let's see. Let me show you the drawing of when I actually made this guy. There are a few dots involved. I like his neck. I think that's my favorite part. It's just so implausible. It kind of looks like a Far Side chicken to me. And then I added approximately 1.5 million dots because dots. There we go. So that's how I drew him. So, let's see. Where are we? Did my tweet about the stream? And let's see. All right, great. So, here we've got my kobold. My precious, precious kobold, which I drew for PJ Stoneson on Twitter. So, first things first, of course, I can't live with a merely purple pixelscapes. I need my regular one. Let's see, where did I put them? Working template. I'm gonna move that down here just so I can get everything. All right, he's pretty straightforward. So I'm gonna just start selecting stuff. I guess I'll leave my chicken white. No, I'm gonna make my chicken red and orange. Let's make the chicken. How about that? Oh, and here's my sketch that I did in blue. So, chicken, chicken. Bok, bok, bok. Whoop, and the top of his head. Make a color layer. Colors. Chicken. Go make my chicken orange. But he kind of looks like a cooked chicken, so I'm gonna have to red that up. Okay. Chicken feet. Oh, select, deselect. I'm going to make these as bright as possible. And probably a completely different color, like pink. Sure, why not? All right, and in that case, maybe I'll make his beak pink also. So my kobold has to be, I think, yellow, and then the dots will be pink green. So let's get him situated. Arm, tail, ankle, hand bits, also known in some vicinities as fingers. And then I'm gonna do some green painting on him, just because straight yellow is a little monotonous. But I'm gonna have to select him one part at a time to do that. So let's get his face first. Not there on the color layer, please. And then I'll get his arms. Which means I gotta reselect his fingers. I haven't had any like green and yellow things lately, so I'm pleased about this. And then I need his foot. Whoops. Smaller. Dots. Select. Load selection. Dots. And then let's make these dots do something other than just be green. Like, I could make them. Yeah, that's kind of. Sure, why not? And then let me try making maybe some layer style. I can emboss them. Let me zoom in so I can see what I'm doing. Just a slight emboss, like he's a warty. Like he's warty. I like it. Yeah, that's good. It's actually a little bit more than I would prefer. Let me just make it a little more transparent. Okay, let's see. Scale dots. Move scale dots. Okay, so he's got a little bit of blue on him, so I'm gonna make his, no. I wanna, so let's see, I've used red and orange and pink. I want to make his, now's the time I should probably pick the ring colors, because that will help me figure out what I'm doing with his clothes. Let's see. Interesting. Okay. I'm gonna actually, you see how this goes straight into his, and then, yeah, I'm gonna have to change him a little. Filter, liquify. I don't like that that spike goes straight into the edge of the ring. This is a thing we can change. There we go. And then I just do that same thing on all the relevant layers. Okay. Great. It is an unfortunate tangent otherwise. Okay, let's see. Oh right, I was coloring the ring. So let's grab the inside ring. Inner ring color. So he's pretty light. I think we need some blue to purplish going on here. And the chicken has a lot of pink, so I don't want to make it on that side. Other way. Yeah. I kind of prefer vertical gradients. How about that? No. I'll do like a legit vertical one. I like it, but I'm gonna have to change the color of the chicken bits. So that's what I will do. Hello, PJ! If that's what you want me to call you. Look, I'm coloring your kobold. How awesome is that? Outer ring color. Let's see. Okay, so I've used pretty much every color. Let's see. Okay, green. I could use meh. Or Paul. Okay, got it. Thank you. Yes. PJ or Paul is the person who suggested that I draw a kobold. Or kobold, depending on how you want to say it. And I've very much been enjoying it. So let's see. What color can this be? I guess I could do red and pink. Okay. I'll do orange. I don't want to blend in the chicken. See. Yeah. That's better. I don't know. I gotta think about this. But now that I have the gradient there, I can think with visuals. Green blends in with him. That medium blue is pretty good. I'm gonna do that instead. Select. And then I'm gonna get edit, fill. And then I'll be able to select, modify, expand by 125. Modify feather. I'm gonna do 100. Okay. Yeah. So it's like a glowy ring instead of a vertical one. I still have to change that chicken. Let me change that before. Now that I know what the neighboring colors are, I can do that. So let's change chicken feet first. They could be red, but what's the fun in that? How about blue? And now that means I need the color areas for this. Okay. Now I need to get his shirt. Which probably is going to involve a lot of selecting, since I very sensibly drew a bazillion little lacings here. So let's see. Oh, I'm an idiot. Why don't I just select the whole damn thing? Chaos. Let's see. So he can have a blue shirt, just like the edge. But make it too dark or the chicken will blend. Okay. And as for his pants, they could be pink. With some virulent purple, perhaps. Okay. He's not really dressed for stealth, but let me change the color a little so it doesn't blend quite so much. All right, his poor teeth need color. That tolerant kobold, whatever he is. And let me do the back of his head too, since now I finally know what I'm doing. I'll make him stop. Stop it. Yes, welcome to Jen's Frustrated Noises channel. Okay. Oh, no, no, no. No. Do some shading. I'm shading away. Okay. Then I got eyes. I will have eyes. Yeah, let's see. Where are the eyes? Oh, I put them on that layer, did I? Very well then. Shush. The chicken and his eyes are both orange because he's thinking about eating this chicken. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. Okay, Now I want to do this knife. New. Dagger, because this is D&D. All right, and I'm gonna go use my precious, my metal filter that I love so much. Filter. The poor chicken, he doesn't know though. See, he doesn't understand. He's a chicken. Sometimes they don't even notice when their head's cut off. I think I need to change his beak color again later, by the way. Whoops. No. I'm not sure if you guys can see this. I will try to be quick. Liquid metal, chrome. No. Here's a filter called Peaceful. It's peaceful, right? Legit. Okay, I think I can shrink this down so it's actually where you guys can see it. Oh well. And I don't like this filter. I gotta select a new one. I'm gonna use gold. Because then I can change it if I want. Yeah, okay. Now I just wait for it to come back. Oh, I can't fix the chicken meanwhile. Damn. Well, that's fine. What I'm going to do is add a little bit of shading to the blue. PGH Fett says, poor chicken, look at his eyes. He knows. You think so? You think this chicken knows anything with this face? I think he's spaced out. That's what I think. All right. Okay, there's the knife. It's good enough for me, but I can't let it be like brown. It's gotta be like horrifyingly oversaturated, and maybe a different color. Kind of like the gold, actually. It like sort of as a counterpoint to the chicken. But a counterpoint to the chicken is not a phrase that I imagined that I would be saying tonight, but I should have known. Because chicken. Right. Well, I wanna add a little straight color to the dagger, just so when I do color shifts later, it doesn't have a monotony, total monotony. And it looks like a banana, but I'll fix that. Okay. That's good. Let me just test how this will hue shift in practice. Let's see. Okay. Cancel. All right. Chicken. My precious chicken. All right. Let's see. And I was going to add some purple, right? And then on under the colors, I don't like that. I'm gonna put it somewhere else. I'm gonna put it on the top of his beak, and then on the top of the comb. And I'm gonna change the color just a little, so it's not quite so dark. But does it look like a hole? I don't think it does, because now it has the shading. That's my theory. We'll see. How much did I actually... Maybe I should make it something else entirely. Like... Well, not green. I can't make it blue, because the edge... Orange is too much like it is now. I guess I'll just leave it the purplish, pinkish. Plus 21. That's what I need for the feet. Okay. Feet. Oh, hush. It's not empty. Don't give me that. Oh, because I still have a selection. There's fireworks going off in the background. That's interesting. Okay. Okay. Well, let me add my brush strokes texture, and then I might want to make the chicken have feather texture. I'm not sure yet. So that was 30. make the background move 30. And make the outer ring move 30. Okay. And then I'm gonna move all these things back because I don't want it to be totally. Yeah. That makes it a little more contrasty on the chicken. Minus 50. No. Actually, it's better that way. Okay. And then on the background, do I want it? I guess that really is the best background. And then on the outer ring, minus 15. So it matches as a shirt. Okay. I'm not sure if this chicken needs more texture, but he's awfully textured. Let's just for giggles, let me check pixels. For feathers. There's an actual chicken, but I don't want an actual chicken. This'll work. This image brought to you by Pexels, which has public domain images, which is super convenient. Okay, I'm gonna extract my chicken. The chicken body, anyway. Oh, and I need the top of his head too. His or her head. Select inverse. Delete. All right, now where's my precious feathers? Feathers. Be big enough scale that it works. So I'll go like, Okay. No. No. Moving these feathers away. You found a chicken emote. Yes, they are reddish brown, but I've seen illustrations of them being green. And either way. I make things crazy colors. I could change the color completely when we're done, if you really want them to be reddish brown. But I do color variants, so I could show you that when I'm done. Let's see. Okay, so here's the feathers that I kept. Why are there two here? I will always remember the evening that I spent lovingly feathering a chicken. Last but not least, tail feathers. Shake your tail feathers, chicken. And I forgot the top of his head again. Well, I'm gonna go fake it. Okay. So that's my selector for the feathers. Now I have a couple ways I can go. Oh, I see what I did. Okay. Select inverse, edit, fill with black. It's okay. I knew that would happen. All right, And then I want to get my chicken. No, not that. Not that either. All right. And then I want to select that. Okay, chicken. Prepare to be really feathered. Here we go. Not green. Red and purple's kind of fun. But I don't think I want to go quite that deep. Okay. Okay, there's my chicken. Yes, the chicken glows in the dark. It is clearly radioactive chicken. It's really the only explanation, the only possible explanation. Chicken feet shadow. Okay. Oh, I didn't want to do that. I want to add the lines to that. And then move it down. I'm not going to leave it all shadowed. Shadows on ring. And then this one is going to be much more subtle, like that. Actually, I'm going to make the shadows on the ring a little more subtle too, because I don't want them jet black. Ooh, there's a thing I can do. Select, load selection. No. I have to do another copy before I do that. Select inverse. What did I do? Did I messed up my thing. Inside shadows. Okay. Select load selection inside shadows. And then I'm gonna. Just for giggles, try something. What? Select load selection. Why isn't that working? What's going on? It's not. Oh, that's why. Okay. Because I'm an idiot. That's why. Let me try this one more time. Select load selection. Yes. Okay. And then I want to, instead of making it a shadow, I want to do it here. As a color shift. Does it? It's interesting. Not sure if I like that better though. I don't think I do. All right, I'm gonna put it back, but I'm gonna make it barely there. This probably is the least interesting part of the stream when I'm like fussing at the end. Okay. Okay. Then let's see. That means I gotta move my pixelscapes because there is a shadow here that I gotta delete. That leg goes behind. It shouldn't be shadowing there. And then, actually, I'll put it right here. Okay, now I want to do line colors because Lord knows I love me some line colors. So first I'm going to do the token ring colors. Ring line colors. And that's going to be select load selection. Probably blue. I mean, or purple. Purple's good. Because they're already in the neighborhood, you know? Okay. And then for colors on the cobalt, I'm not sure. I just haven't decided. Select load selection, lines transparency, colored lines. Like, I could use a good blue. I mean, I could use green, but that's not a very, that would just kind of blend. Maybe I'll just put some blue in his clothes. His nose. And on his tail, I guess. And on his claws. Ooh, that means I should probably get his hand too, huh? Yeah, but then I gotta isolate this dagger. Let me get that. No. Oh, I see what it did. I'll fix it. All right. His eyes were on that layer, so they're coming up as blue, so they're picking up my airbrushing. I want them clean. Okay. And then I guess I'll make the sparkle on his knife. Let's see. I'll use red. With a little bit of yellow. One of these days I'm going to go back and look at this video and see that I spend like well over half the time just fussing around. And then what did I use again for him? Blue? I'm gonna throw a little bit of pink on his chicken. All right, maybe he's done. Let's see. Yeah, that looks good. I like it. The colored lines make a big difference. It's a little, the blue is a little dark on his clothes. The blue lines, I mean, I'm gonna erase that a little. Oh, I didn't put blue on his other hand. How am I going to do that? One of these days I'll learn to draw my critters on like separate layers. All right. PGH FET, rather. I have a question for you. Does it really bother you that he's green in the default version? Like, should I shift this whole thing so that the cobalt is more orange? Would you like that? Because that's a thing I can do. So you're good with him being green? I can always make a color variant. I mean, I always make all six color variants. Well, thank you very much. I like how it turned out. Let's see, what time is it? And it is time for me to go. So this is actually convenient timing. So thank you all very much. This has been a load of fun. And I will see you out on Twitter and elsewhere on the interwebs. Great. See ya. Thank you. Bye-bye.